The total revenue test says that demand for a good is elastic if you can lower the price and raise the total revenue. Now, any other combination equivalent to that would be just as good for this test. Let's take these points, X and Y. X is at a quantity of 3 and a price of 8, so that means that we would have a total revenue of 8 times 3. Point Y is at a quantity of 4 and a price of 7, that means we'd have a total revenue of 28. You see that we lowered the price and the total revenue increased, so this is an elastic portion of the demand curve. Here we have the revenue at point X and point Y, and they're overlapping each other. And we can see what happens when you lower the price, you increase the quantity. When you lower the price, those first three customers who were paying $8, they get to pay a dollar less, so you're going to lose $3 in revenue. But then you sell an extra unit for $7, and that more than offsets your revenue loss, so your total revenue increases. Maybe that's all you need to know, and you can stop the video right now. Or you can follow along with me as we do a calculation. Let's calculate the price elasticity of demand between X and Y. Now, I'm going to talk about moving from X to Y, but we will do the calculations with the midpoint formula so that you would get the same answer if you went from Y to X. The elasticity is equal to a percentage change in quantity divided by a percentage change in price. So our percentage change in quantity is equal to 4 minus 3 divided by the midpoint, which is 3.5. If you turn that into a fraction, you get 2 over 7. I'm going to do the percentage change in price numbers in purple. They will be in the denominator here. The price went from 8 to 7, so we will take 7 minus 8 divided by the midpoint. That's going to equal negative 2 over 15. Now we have this complex fraction. We can basically turn the denominator into 1 by multiplying by its reciprocal. And because it's a fraction, if you multiply the entire fraction by 1, you're not going to change its value. So let's also multiply the numerator by that reciprocal. Then those 2s cancel, and you're left with negative 15 over 7. We know that a price elasticity of demand will be negative, so if we just take the absolute value, you get 15 over 7, and that number is greater than 1, so it's elastic. Now this demand curve is linear. The slope is the same everywhere. Let's not confuse slope with elasticity. We just calculated the slope between points X and Y and found that was elastic. I want you to go ahead and calculate what is the elasticity between points A and B. Is that elastic or inelastic? You can go ahead and check your answer in the video description.